Guys, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to yet another video. Thank you so much for tuning in, very much welcome. Just in case we've got new viewers, thank you so much for choosing Pilile Papra's Entertainment. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video as well, and yeah, share it as well to your friends and family. Don't forget to invite more people, guys, so that we can grow. But thank you guys for taking your time to tune into the channel. Now let us get down to this one, guys. We are going to be talking about Khumalo. I see here they are saying Khumalo could be subpoenaed to be grilled about her alleged involvement in the 2014 murder case of soccer star in 2014. Remember, after Advocate Mungomezulu said he's planning to subpoena Khumalo, and is it Khumalo and Longwe, and is it Longwe or Longwe's father, something like that, you guys, because it is believed the Senzo Meyiwa might have been shot by Longwe Twala during the scuffle between Zandi Khumalo, who's a Khumalo's sister, and Longwe, her then boyfriend, and then Senzo was there, as the family was there together with the Senzo and his two friends, and yeah, I mean, you guys, so kwakusendlini akuboka Khumalo and Khumalo's mother's house in Fort Lauderdale. Senzo Meyiwa lost his life there, you guys. There's a lot that has been going on, you know, you guys. I've been doing as well my videos, but even though I do not follow the story too much, but I only come when there's kind of like a serious story. So lately Mungomezulu came to say, you guys, the information that he has is that Senzo Meyiwa passed away during a scuffle between Zandi and Longwe, and then he was trying to get involved to separate the fight, and then he got shot, something like that. So there's a lot that is happening, you guys. They say they're trying to subpoena Chiko Twala, and we saw his response saying what the fly-by-night lawyer, when he meant Mungomezulu, that he's taking chances, he's a fly-by-night lawyer, trying to call him for something that happened when he was not there in the Iganjaligas. But we understood what he was called, and he was the first one to arrive in hospital, so he might have something that he knows, according to me. So why is he refusing to go to court, something like that, you guys? And Khumalo, a lot of people have been saying, why is it that they are not calling Khumalo to come and testify at court, you guys? And I will come to Babu Ivan, because I don't want to go get to that too much, you guys, because it is something that was said by Usifiso Meyiwa, saying he heard from Ukhoza, so they were just trying to subpoena those people to come and testify. There's a lot that is going on. So here they are talking about Ukele Khumalo's career is said to be hanging by a thread. After she was fingered in Senzo Meyiwa's murder. Okay, now people were saying on Twitter, when I followed the Khumalo post, she was trending. People were saying, no, you guys, you are lying. This girl's life is going according to order. She's okay. She's getting other gigs. While here on the story, they were saying she's not getting any gigs because of this Senzo Meyiwa thing. I would like to understand, though, if she's going through something because of this. But there were people who were saying, no way. She's busy every week. She's getting booked. So I do not know, you guys. But on the story here, they're saying she always grabs headlines for being embroiled in salacious scandals. And it has become quite clear that when it rains, it pours for singer Ukele Khumalo. According to the sources, the singer has lost money after not securing bookings following some recent lurid revelations in the North Gauteng High Court in Pretoria. I guess it's because I'm talking too much. Okay. in the North Gauteng High Court in Pretoria that paint here as the mastermind behind the murder of her late boyfriend and baby daddy Senzo Meyiwa in 2014. Now, but her career hangs in the balance, you guys. As like I said, some people were arguing that. So I did not know, because we don't know Khumalo, but we only, you know, read online. It is said that her singing career is hanging by the balance, as gigs are far and few between. Promoters are apparently wary of booking the singer because of fears of reputational damage after confession statements from accused number one, Moses Bia, and number two, Ubongani Danzi, in the Senzo Meyiwa murder trial, implicated Kelly as the mastermind. Judge Rata Mokgatleng ruled in a trial within a trial that the Danzi and CBS confession statements were admissible. Now, in the confession statements read in court last month by witness Lieutenant Colonel Moholo Solomon Rapadu, Colonel Mhlanganyelwa Mboto, the two accused say they were briefed that the person who initiated the hit was Ukele, who they allege paid them 100,000 rands for the murder. Now, the gigs, Ama gigs, are getting cancelled every time. Maybe some get cancelled, maybe some do not, because people were arguing, because I did not know. But Ama gigs, they are cancelled and they are just far away between, you know, and a girl is kind of like struggling. And it is alleged, you guys, I do not know. Now, the source, who is also in the music industry, said Ukele had a lot of gigs lined up until the revelations in court. After the startling revelations were made, they shrunk. Promoters don't want to touch her because obviously they know what is going on with the court case. Some of her bookings have been cancelled because of this drama, revealed a source. Uti, I was booked at the same event with her, but I was shocked to find out she wouldn't be performing anymore because she was cancelled at the 11th hour. Now, an artist who wished to remain anonymous told Uzimoja, now they don't want to risk it by having her until she is proven innocent, keeping in mind that Senzo had a huge following, so they also don't want to upset people. This is what they are saying. It is going on around Kelly Khumalo, you guys. Now, worried about the future prospects, Ukele is who is signed to Universal Music, appears unbothered by the happenings in the court. But deep down, she is apparently worried by what this means for her freedom and her career. She is obviously stressed but doesn't want to show it because she knows people want to see her down because they've been throwing accusations against her for many years. Now, she's always painted herself as a victim in throughout the debacle, but things have changed. She could stand in the dog. Okay, Khumalo. Meanwhile, things are becoming more interesting in the case as the star could be forced to take the stand to tell her side of the story, which is what a lot of people want. A lot of people want Kelly Khumalo to come and testify, and they are not bringing that Kelly. But I would like to understand the reasons, you guys. So this is the defense of one of the accused. He has requested to subpoena the singer so she can answer questions about her alleged involvement in the case. An investigation in the murder case, Sergeant in the murder case, Sergeant Ubatu Mohola told the court this week during cross-examination by advocate Ushals Mnisi, who is representing accused number 3, Umtobisi Mnube, that she does not know why the alleged mastermind behind the killing, who is known to the police, has not been arrested or charged. Mohola testified that according to the investigation and her briefings with the lead investigator, Brigadier Bongani Kininda, all the accused were linked to an alleged mastermind through cell phone analysis. Efforts to solicit a comment from MP Nisinga drew a blank as she didn't revert to questions sent to her, even though she was offered ample time to do so, you guys. Remember, Gwatua Kelly Khumalo is a mastermind behind all this. There was 100,000 money that was spoken about to Kelly paid for the hit of singer for the footballer Senzo Meyiwa, you guys, who was her boyfriend and her baby daddy at the time. And then there's another story of Longwe and Zandi fighting, and then the gun shoots Senzo Meyiwa and he passes away. So I do not know, you guys, between the two, which one is it, but Mina, I wanna believe it is the one that we had in the beginning. Kuti Ulongo was fighting Uzandi, and then Usenzo got in the middle of the situation. I like to believe that one, but anyways, I do not know about the 100,000 one. Kelly Khumalo being the mastermind, actually hiring the Nkabis to remove Usenzo Meyiwa, you guys, to delete him or to unalive him, something like that. So, but Kelly Kumalo's career is hanging by a thread since Akatole Ama bookings, and you know what? My promoters, they do not want to touch Kelly Khumalo because by us, what is happening in the North Gauteng High Court, and Kelly is kind of like pretending as if everything is okay when it is not, and all this is alleged, you guys. Mina, I do not know. So yeah, I mean, it is what it is, but people were arguing on Twitter saying, no, this girl is okay, this girl, you guys, so we do not know. They were saying, no, she's booked every week, she's okay at all my gigs, but she gets my gigs, but they are just like far away apart from each other. How fans are going to react when it comes to Kelly Khumalo performing and into Ganjalo. So they do not want to touch it at the moment, maybe until she is proven innocent. So girl, into as hambi gatle. That's what I heard, you guys. But anyways, those who are saying no, she's okay, maybe those are close friends and whatever, you guys, close family friends or her fans. Remember, she also has friends, fans abantu abam konzile, something like that, you guys. But hambi gatle at the moment due to what what is happening in court. Everything is alleged, of course. Thanks so much for watching this video. Share your thoughts on the comment section. Like the video, subscribe, share, and then I'll meet you again on my next upload. Bye.